Yes, what?
Excuse me?
The UC's fleet must be the strongest out there. Now and always. There is no alternative. Welcome back. Did you find your answers?
Not only that, but we found someone there, alive. A child born from two of the crew that survived the crash. After her parents died, that poor girl spent years surviving on that hostile world, alone. We abandoned her, Admiral. We let her down.
I'm sorry. I had no idea. How could we have possibly known? Sona. Is that her name? She must be a remarkable young woman.
She's extraordinary, Admiral. And I'm afraid the United Colonies let her down.
You're absolutely right, Sarah. We did let her down. One thing that I can assure you is that the names of these men and women will never be forgotten. I'll see to it personally.
Thank you, Admiral.
Good luck to both of you. It's been an honor.
Once we're done here, we should have a little talk with Sona. Poor thing's waiting for us at the lodge. I'm eager to explore the universe. There's nothing quite like the feeling of returning home.
Krix's bones. Look at you.
If you don't mind, I'm gonna start doing some scans. Like, right now.
We were right about the anomaly, weren't we? Tip our ears on the tail. An entire building generating a signature just like the artifact.
Vladimir? Look at these readings. Cardiovascular and neurological levels aren't in the normal range.
I think we're going to need a little demonstration. Mind putting the paces to it? Now that those artifacts aren't just blips of hope in the Blackest Sea, I found an interesting pattern. The grav anomaly generated by one of those artifacts, it matches one on another planet, a bigger one. All right, let me transfer over the data. But I need you wearing caution's boots for this one. No telling what this thing is or why it's so large. Going to send you the mark close as I can, but I'm having trouble pinpointing the source. You'll need to explore the area on foot. Put your scanner to work. Don't know what you'll find. Keep your eyes open. And from there, maybe you catch a smile and uncover the source of it all.
We should probably talk. There you are. I was wondering when you'd come and say hi to me. Yeah, it was kind of hard though. All these people around. Never seen so many people in my entire life. I think I like it. I don't know yet, but it's all really new to me. At the lodge? Yeah, this place is huge. I mean, I've never seen anything like it. You must be like a bazillionaire, Sarah. Whoa. Does that mean I get to go exploring with both of you? Or wait, do I get my own ship? I understand. Oh, Oh, and don't worry. I learn real fast. So you better get ready to have another member of Constellation signing on for missions. Well, anyway, thanks for letting me stay here. I promise I won't let either of you down.
Welcome to Reliant Medical. If you're injured,
well, judging by...
So, what brings you in today? Oh my, it's a good thing you came in to see me. All right, we'll clean things up and get you back out into the world. Good as new. Well, you've certainly come to the right place. May you remain in good health.
Everyone saw that, right?
Like a literal gift from the heavens.
And also the most practical consequence of our little venture thus far.
Got no old shipwise for this one. Going to just call weird, weird. Well, I suppose we can't stop you. But I'm joining the Deny Everything to the Public Club for a while.
Seconded. I must insist that you exercise caution when using your newfound abilities.
Can we find more of them?
Already picked one up from the scans. Matches another one of the artifacts we found. In theory, There might be one temple for each. But sifting through all the signs to identify a match is tricky. Impossible if we don't have the right artifact to compare. And even then, it takes time. You'd still need to cross-reference the artifacts we have with the data from the Eye to pinpoint the source. It's a strong theory. Couldn't find that planetary anomaly without the data from the artifact. We'll need one to find the other. Don't think it's just fortune's laugh that this temple responded to you. The artifacts, the visions, this power you've gotten, all seems to be the same song somehow. Plenty to think about. Anyway, catch a smile out there. I'll work on finding planet anomalies that match the other artifacts we have.
Bet you never expected to end up involved in something like this.
Nice to see you again. Sure, go ahead. Maybe we'll talk later?
I am at your service, Captain.
I guess we need to talk. There you are. I was wondering...
Hello, Sona. I see you found your way to the lodge without any trouble.
Yeah, it was kind of hard, though. All these people around. Never seen so many people in my entire life. They sure won't. They have to catch me first.
It's true. You're one of the toughest people I've ever met. So, what do you think? Do you like it here, Sona?
At the lodge? Yeah, this place is huge. I mean, I've never seen anything like it. You must be like a bazillionaire, Sarah.
Oh, don't I wish? This place isn't mine alone. It belongs to everyone who's a part of Constellation. And I think it should belong to you too, Sona. I want you to stay here and make this your home.
Whoa! Does that mean I get to go exploring with both of you? Or wait, do I get my own ship?
Well, Auntie Sarah can't exactly afford that right now, but she can provide you with the best exploration training in the galaxy.
I understand. Oh, and don't worry, I learn real fast, so you better get ready to have another member of Constellation signing on permissions.
I can't wait.
Well, anyway, thanks for letting me stay here. I promise I won't let either of you down.
I'm sure that you won't. Well, I think we should let Sona get settled. If you wouldn't mind, I'd like to visit the Colony War Memorial now. I want to pay my final respects. The Colony War Memorial is actually quite lovely, in a solemn sort of way. If you'll just bear with me, I promise I'll explain everything.
If you want to talk, make it quick. I think I'm late for Noelle's science lesson.
argument for both.
Friend, what's the point of grab jumping to new planets if we can't even breathe the air?
What's new with you today?
Look at this. All these people, their entire lives distilled down to names on a memorial. I wonder how close I came to being reduced to just a name. I am proud. I was simply too foolish to realize it until you changed my perspective. And I care about you too. There's obviously some kind of a connection between us that I think we need to discuss. Just let me have another moment here, and then we can head over to the waterfall, so we can talk in private. Okay, I'm ready. Let's go.
Yes, exactly.
Maybe we should stop for a moment at the memorial. You know, to pay our respects.
It's not much further. I think you'll want to hear what I have to say after we arrive at the waterfall. If you'll just bear with me, I promise I'll explain everything.
lovely here, isn't it? I've been from one end of the settled systems to the other. But this place, this exact spot, there's nowhere else like it in the galaxy. I usually come up here to mull over some of the heated debates we have at Constellation. You'd be surprised how many decisions I've made on this very spot. That's actually why I asked you to meet me up here. I was hoping we could talk about something very important. No, not at all. Just let me get all of this out. I have a lot to say. It's about my return to Cassiopeia. What we learned about Sona has been constantly replaying in my mind. Oh, maybe it sounds crazy, but that young girl's isolation feels like a reflection of my own life. In all honesty, I don't. She simply reminds me of my own isolation. Maybe not in the literal sense of the word, but I certainly relate to some of her loneliness. My life surrounded by all sorts of people. Constellation, the Navigator Corps, hell, even the UC military. Despite that, no matter how hard I've tried to make them a part of my life, they tend to drift away and disappear. Are you sure? For all we know, it's in my nature to keep people at arm's length. Or worse, push them away. Right now? Are you talking about Constellation? Or what exactly are you saying? Sorry, I just need a moment to gather my thoughts.
I know you want to have a serious relationship. You want to become close. So, if you're willing to take that leap of faith with someone like me, then I'm ready to do the same. Something truly special. You know that? You've helped me conquer my self-doubt, my confidence, hell, everything. For the first time in my life, I feel complete. And with you by my side, I'm convinced that feeling will last forever. You're the best thing that's happened to me in my life. I love you. Always.
In the market for artwork, I'm sure I can find something to suit your needs.
Getting a Deimos.
Really?
Thank you.
you know? I'm sure you already know there's no... Please, take a look.
I received a message from my mother a few days ago. She's returned from another one of her sightseeing cruises. Yeah, you know, one of those luxury liner journeys that shows off binary stars, gas nebulas, asteroid fields. Pretty photogenic stuff. Apparently, it's my mother's new favorite pastime. Ah, that's right. I haven't really spoken about her to you, have I? My mother lives in a fairly remote location, so we rarely speak. Tends to keep her out of my mind. Good. When I say that to most people, they look at me like I'm crazy. I don't think they realize how much control parents can exert on your life, especially when their dreams conflict with your own. I'm certain they felt they were doing the right thing. You see, both of my parents were diplomats working under the flag of the UC Administrative Division. After I completed my basic education, they signed me up for a one-year apprenticeship in their department, without bothering to ask. Wanted isn't the right word. Demanded would be more appropriate. For my apprenticeship, I was sent to Cydonia. My job consisted of drafting political policies and arbitrating trade disputes. The silver lining of the job was that it allowed me to spend time exploring every square inch of Mars. I was swallowed by it. Months before the apprenticeship ended, I dumped my diplomatic certification and joined the UC Navy. Of course, my parents didn't approve. We had a huge argument that resulted in all ties being severed between us. Well, that wasn't the worst of it. You see, my father was killed during the opening shots of the Colony War. I returned to Jemison for the funeral and reunited with my mother. After that, we vowed to stay in touch. Oh, aren't you sweet? Always concerned with how I'm feeling. That's why I fell in love with you. Your smile, your caring, it brightens even my darkest days. Listen, I'm going to be completely upfront with you. All this talk of family, it makes me wonder where our own relationship stands.
Take your time. I don't mind waiting. And I love you too. And who knows? Maybe one day we can discuss how we turn that love into a future for the both of us. When you have a few moments, there's something I'd like to discuss. Now that we have a moment, I wanted to ask how you're feeling. After your experience at the temple, you've given everyone at the lodge quite a scare. Why am I concerned? Let's think for a moment. Ah, yes. It isn't exactly an everyday occurrence to stumble across a mysterious temple and absorb some type of strange alien energy from within. I find that to be rather surprising. According to what I've heard, your body absorbed an almost unquantifiable amount of energy of a type we can't even begin to understand. We're dealing with something unknown to modern science. Who knows how this encounter has affected your body or your mind? I know you're simply trying to brush this off with humor, but you really should act more concerned. That temple proves we're dealing with entities of unknown origin. The problem is that we can't even begin to guess what their intention was towards us and where they've gone. It's a possibility I've considered, but I'm not 100% convinced. The only thing we can be certain of is that the technology we've encountered points to beings that live outside the settled systems. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm afraid my curious mind is once again overriding my manners. It's just that... Oh, I'm afraid that we're flying almost completely blind here. All we know for certain at this point is that whoever created the artifacts are the same beings that built the temple. Anything else is just guesswork. I might as well put on a blindfold and toss darts at theories written on the wall. As far as Constellation's concerned, you're the first human we're aware of that's ever encountered one of these places. Now, whether you consider that lucky or not, that's another matter entirely. Oh, believe me, this is positively exhilarating. Think about the significance of this research. The questions it raises alone are mind-boggling. Who was this wondrous structure built to accommodate? How long ago did these entities inhabit our universe? Are they still out there, somewhere? Perhaps. We'll need more data to be sure. It's funny. I used to think the artifacts were the end-all be-all of scientific discovery, the pinnacle mystery of our time. Never in my wildest dreams did I imagine it would lead to something of this magnitude. I just hope that you'll come through this, whatever it is, unharmed.
Well, yes, of course you are. I was speaking of the power you've acquired. This is all scientifically speaking, of course. Look, I've already taken up too much of your time. All I can do is promise that I'm not going to make you deal with this mystery alone. Whatever might be happening, I'll be right here to help you every step of the way.
Take us in.
Thank you.
sharp-edged raw materials. This facility is an accident just waiting to happen. Set aside anything useful and just leave the rest. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
find you!
Not gonna last much longer.
Stock up and jump.
I am not a stud.
But their shipboard system literally uses quantum synergy software to talk to the hardware. What if that
you look like someone
Amoli,
who
I'm
has
not seeing any records from the hauler out of Sidonia.
Like
what was his name again? When's the last time he delivered?
Oh, that guy.
A blade? Oh my. As in a blade from Earth? Absolutely. Without question. Here, take the gem. That Guillaume, if he wanted his gem back so badly, he could have simply asked. The gem is worthless, less than a paperweight. But actually, Earth paperweights are quite valuable.
That's very unfortunate. To secure some other supplier.
And let me guess, it's gonna be more expensive.
Bah! I'm sure Guillaume makes it seem that way. In reality, it couldn't be further from the truth. Guillaume and I have known each other for years, since we were both young men. He is the closest thing I have to a brother. And, much like brothers, we quarrel. But that doesn't mean we don't like each other. I will say, however, Guillaume can be a tad overdramatic, as well as a sore loser. Don't tell him I said that.
I won't even have... Ah, wonderful. I knew George would make the exchange. He could never resist foodware from Earth. You've done me a great service today, friend. I'll be sure to never take this gem for granted ever again. Thank you for bringing it back to me. Until next time...
Some work done? Sure, have at it. I'm sure you can find something you like. I'm sure you can find something you like. How about it?
just isn't the same as the real thing.
Things 5x5, Captain.
Got a new assignment for me?
Aimpoint reached. Orbit stable.
Levels look good, suit integrity normal. Hope this place is worth the trouble.
Good to see you again, Dusty. Seems like you've been keeping busy, Dusty. If, you find yourself in need of a capable traveling my contract's up. Works for me. I'm not fussy about assignments. I'll go where I'm needed. Right. I'll get to work. Let's catch up later.
All systems looking good, boss.
Setting down.
If we pull anything organic off this rock. I'm sure there's something nearby.